I know every now and then we are men have been guilty of sin, but I wanted to know here tonight at Holiday Inn, by round of applause, can I just do one piece for the men? One piece. I figured out the relationship problem. Here we go. I'm looking for a gay dude. That's right, I said it. I'm looking for a gay dude. This piece is not meant to be offensive or rude, but yeah, Black Ice is live here at the Holiday Inn telling y'all that I'm looking for a gay dude. Okay, let me explain. See, y'all, I got this girl, right? And things started off tight, we were cool, and I tried my best to follow all the relationship rules. Rules like being available when she calls, answering her texts in a decent amount of time, giving her compliments by telling her from time to time that, baby, you sexy and fine, but most of all, trying to stay consistent. Even times when she would be persistent were crossover time. Fellas, y'all know, time that wasn't time that we would normally spend together, but she would cross over to that time. Which means that I would have to find time to make time because she added time to her time, which means that I had less time than I had dedicated to me time because a lot of my me time became she time, and that's why I'm looking for a gay dude. I said it was time that wasn't time that we would normally spend together, but she would cross over into their time. Which means that I'll have to find time to make time because she added time to her time, which means that I had less time than I had dedicated to me time because a lot of my me time became she time, and that's why I'm looking for a gay dude. Now, in the meantime, she's building frustration with my hesitation. See, in her mind, I'm becoming inconsistent. But in my mind, she just got more persistent. And herein lies the relationship dilemma. She's claimed that I changed, when actually my actions remain the same. It's just that both of our feelings have changed. And yeah, it's true, we don't talk on the phone for hours at a time anymore. But let me explain. If you add up the 30 minutes here, the 15 minutes there, the talk time on my way to work, on my lunch break, and on my ride home, then it all adds up the same. And that's why I'm looking for a gay dude. One she can talk to about all of her work drama. He can ride with her when she go and visits her mama. And on a trip when she would spend hours at the mall, then guess who she can call? They can do it. They can hold hands. Gossip for hours on end. Talk to him about the drama of her girlfriends and their breakups. Ask him to critique all of my hairstyles and her makeup. Sit and chat all day and drink lattes at Starbucks. Stand in line at Walgreens when she's buying her pants and her feminine products. That's what I'm looking for a gay dude. This piece is not meant to be offensive or rude, but meant to give you things from a different perspective. The objective? To show you that my love can't be played by the quantity of my conversation, but by the quality of my dedication. And just in case some of y'all asses still having reservations, that's why I'm looking for a gay dude. Now, when I found that gay dude, the relationship turned out to be okay. Until I found out that that motherfucker wasn't really gay. That's why you gotta be careful when you're looking for a gay dude. That's the peace, y'all.
Put your hands up in there, come on, y'all.
Sweet thing, don't you know you're my everything?
Now, who wanna come up here and hit this high note? Somebody out there wanna come up here and hit this high note?
Don't you know? That stuff I heard him say, they gonna. The dude gonna come on stage and tell Reggie to come off.
You know? Lamar told me to say this. Thank you, Lamar. I said, I guess I don't know, damn. Fuck all that. Damn, you know. I want to pick everybody, boy, out of nickel bags and out of $10 bags. I'll send it.